This instruction video is made for patients like you with complaints of lightheadedness and a tendency to faint in the standing position. Your complaints are caused by a fall in blood pressure and a consequent decrease in perfusion of your brain with lack of oxygen. With the maneuvers that we're going to teach you in this video, we expect that your complaints will diminish or even disappear. When you stand up, blood is displaced from the chest to the lower parts of the body. As a consequence, there is less blood available for the heart to pump, and the circulation in the standing position is less stable than when you are supine, like lying in bed. This figure is a continuous tracing of blood pressure in a healthy person that stands up. In the supine position, blood pressure is stable. When he stands up, there is an initial fall in blood pressure with a low blood pressure after about 15 seconds. Then blood pressure recovers, and after 1 to 5 and 6 minutes standing, blood pressure is at about the same level as supine, but less stable. The initial fall in blood pressure is a normal finding. Most of us are familiar with a brief feeling of dizziness upon standing up rapidly, or for instance by standing up from the squatting position. Fainting can occur in healthy persons even if they're very fit, like in this guard who fainted during prolonged standing. Fainting in guards occurs because too much blood is pooled in the legs during prolonged standing. This figure shows what happens with blood pressure during a faint. The person is standing here for 11, 12 minutes and blood pressure is stable. After 12 minutes, blood pressure is decreasing, and at this point, the person is feeling dizziness, and a moment later he faints. When he falls on the floor, blood pressure recovers again. With the maneuvers we're going to teach you in a moment, you will be able to prevent this fall in blood pressure and the faint. These maneuvers are based on the mechanisms that contraction of leg muscles will decrease the amount of blood in your legs and increase the amount of blood available for the heart to pump. The following maneuvers are used. As a preventive measure, we use leg crossing. Leg crossing increases the tension in your legs and will bring blood back to the chest. If you want to have a stronger effect, you can apply butter clenching. By butter clenching or whole body clenching, you will have a stronger effect and more blood will be brought back to your chest. If the blood pressure falls very rapidly, by far the best maneuver to abort a faint is to squat. By this maneuver, blood is rapidly transferred back to the chest. In the next section, a patient with a very low blood pressure on standing will tell you how helpful these maneuvers are for her in daily life.
In my daily routine, I have low blood pressure. The blood pressure is dropping. It's always there. It's there when I have to get up, stand still for a longer time, or I have to do something that's a physical effort for me. When the blood pressure is dropping, I feel a change in my body. I feel dizziness, I see spots, I have a painful neck, ringing ears, I yawn, and a lightheadedness. To prevent I feel worse or to faint, I contract my muscles, I cross my legs. It prevents that I feel worse or I faint. If this is not enough to disappear my complaints, I will bend forwards, and finally I squat. With all these tricks, it's possible for me to have a daily, normal life. I learned by listening to my body and by trial and error, because I wanted to live a normal life as good as possible. Using my tricks is a normal pattern. It happens automatically. I use it at the schoolyard, waiting in a row, wherever I need it.
We will now demonstrate the effects of the maneuvers on a low blood pressure in standing position in this patient. In patients that faint, blood pressure drops to very low values only occasionally, but in this patient, blood pressure falls every time she stands up. She's therefore an excellent candidate to show you the effects of the maneuvers on a low blood pressure.
We measure blood pressure continuously with an accurate monitor.
At this moment, the patient is in a squatting position and her blood pressure is 146 over 92. Will you please stand up? Now you see that blood pressure is going down immediately. And when she starts feeling a bit dizzy, I'll ask her to cross her legs. I'll wait a little bit. Okay, will you please cross your legs? You now can see that blood pressure increases. And now I'm going to ask her to apply, in addition, total body tensing. Will you please do whole body tensing with your arms like this? And you see that immediately blood pressure is going up much more. Just keep it for a moment there. Blood pressure goes up more and values are now 97 over 71. This is leg crossing alone, and this is leg crossing with total body tensing. Okay, will you please stand relaxed again? Now we wait until the blood pressure is very low. So now you see a blood pressure, a low blood pressure of 72 over 51, and that's a blood pressure that most patients start to have symptoms. And if I now ask her to squat, you will see that blood pressure will increase immediately. Effect is much larger than from leg crossing or whole body tensing. So here at this moment she squats, you see that blood pressure goes up immediately. To the values she had previously. So to sum up, standing leg crossed is helpful as a preventive measure or as a measure if you feel a bit faint. If you feel a bit more faint, additional whole body tensing is helpful. If you think you're really gonna faint, squatting is by far the best maneuver to apply. I'm sure the maneuvers demonstrated by this patient are going to be very helpful for you in daily life. Good luck with applying them.